Students, I am Ishan Trivedi. Welcome you in this video lecture series. Today I am going to discuss about urban class groups and impact of transportation. In this session, I am going to cover about urban class group, which further classified as towns, urban agglomeration, outgrowth, metropolitan city, mega cities, boom town, and niche cities, and the separate theory of impact of transportation. Let us start with the town. As per the Census of India 2011, the urban area is classified as all the places with municipality, corporation, cantonment board or notified town area, committee, etc. And the second criteria is all other places which satisfy these three main criteria. First is a minimum population of 5,000 people, at least a 75% of male working in non-agriculture activity, and at last a density of population more than 400 persons per square kilometer. Next is urban agglomeration. Urban agglomeration occurs when two or more adjacent urban areas agglomerate to form a larger urban area having population more than 20,000 as per Census 2011. It is the area of with or without outgrowth of such town. An urban agglomeration must consist of at least a statutory town where the population is 5,000. In varying local conditions, there are similar other combinations which have been treated as urban agglomeration satisfying basic conditions of contiguity. So this is about urban agglomeration. Next is outgrowth. An outgrowth is a viable unit such as a hamlet or a village and clearly identifiable in terms of its location and boundaries. It is a peripheral area of any village. You can say an outgrowth. For example, university area, railway colony, military campus, port area, these are the outgrowth. These outgrowth come up near a statutory town, outside its statutory limit, but within the revenue limit of a village or a town. As I said earlier, it is just a peripheral area of a town. The outgrowth of a town should possess the urban features in terms of infrastructure and amenities such as pakka road, water supply, drainage, electricity, post office, educational institutions, bank, and medical facilities. As per the Census of India 2011, the number of urban agglomeration and town and outgrowth in India are almost, for the statutory town, it is nearly 4,091 towns. Then census town, it is 3,894. If I am talking about urban agglomeration, then these are 475. Next is metropolitan city. Metropolitan city is a large city with the population in excess of 1 million or you can say 10 lakh and may consist of a number of suburban areas attached to a core city center. The metropolitan city is a center of administration, commerce, and higher education. The urbanization is very high in this metropolitan city area. It is also known as a million plus city containing 43% of India's total urban population as per the census 2011. Next is megacities. Megacities occurs when two or more metropolitan cities lies adjacent to each other forming a continuous urban agglomeration. Usually megacities have the population more than 10 million or you can say 1 crore. In India, the megacities are Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata. Next is boomtown and nick cities. The boomtowns and the nick cities are quite small in terms of population, but when I'm talking about the income spending as compared to mega cities, their rate of growth is higher. If I'm talking about the feature of boomtown, then it contains younger population, higher expenditure per household, emerging as the largest market, following the mega cities and higher growth rate. For example, Surat, Jaipur, Kanpur, Lucknow, Bhopal, these are the boomtowns which emerge as a higher income generated centers. Then nick cities. The population is less as compared to boomtowns. There is also a higher expenditure per household. High growth rate is also found in these nick cities. The examples are Amritsar, Faridabad, Ludhiana, Allahabad, Chandigarh, and Jodhpur. So this is the theory of urban class group. Now understand the impacts of transportation. The impact of transportation are divided into three categories. These are direct impact, indirect impact, and cumulative impacts. Direct impact is further classified as relocation, barriers, and integrative features. If I'm talking about direct impact, in particularly relocation effects, these effects are of physical, emotional, and financial stresses. There is removal of formal and informal social network. Vulnerable businesses include grocery shops, banks, and shopping center, gas station, hotel, motel, restaurant. These are very much affected because of the transportation system. There are also various common facilities such as schools, church, recreation centers as well. Vulnerable population segments, which are elderly, low income families, long term residents, handicapped person, and minority and ethnic group members. There are also families with school age children. When I'm talking about barriers, then roads and rail track can affect the structure, function, and social pattern of surrounding neighborhoods. Physical and psychological barriers are also there, like elderly, young, and resident who travel on foot or bicycle. Isolation of community facilities and services and institutions. So these are the barriers. Then if I'm talking about integrative features, then these are pedestrian walkway, bikeway, and other facilities. If I'm talking about indirect impact of the transportation, then the increased traffic can lead to a psychological embarrassment that reduces the extent and the quality of social interaction in the community. Due to transportation, there may be chances of noise pollution, dust, and debris, and it reduces the safety as well. Loss of parking affecting the operation of business and community facilities. Due to emerging transportation, it attracts many people, and for that there are opening in the new areas, introduction to new settlement, and external intrusion of people, and there is a migration of rural to urban because of these transportation facilities. Then if I'm talking about the cumulative impacts, these are of combined effect of past, present, and future action. Now, environmental impacts on transportation. Transportation has several impact on environment, like emissions that are coming from the vehicles are contributing to air pollution, climate change, noise nuisance, and health risk. Above of all these, the infrastructure has a serious impact on the landscape and the ecosystem as well. In addition to these impact on the environment, the transportation has also other severe impact on the society. Every year, hundreds and thousands of people are killed and injured in accidents, and in highly dense populated area, there are occurrence of high congestion, which ultimately results into time losses. So, before the assessing the trends and the perspective of environmental impact, we have to identify the impact as well. For example, impact from greenhouse gas emission on climate change, impact from the pollutant emission on various problems related to air quality, health and nuisance impact from noise, impact on landscape from infrastructure, impact on biodiversity and ecosystem because of infrastructure fragmenting natural habitats and soil waste in the areas close to transport infrastructure. So I'm ending this session here. I hope you have learned various aspects of urban transportation plan. Thanks for watching this video.